excuse. He didn't do it.
Well, the messenger saw Bonnie alive when Mona was arriving. And then Nona found Bonnie dead after Mona left. Perry, I don't see how you can get out of...
Well, I'll tell you how. You've got to put me on the stand, Perry. I'll tell them exactly what happened. How I personally dictated that blackmail note.
And what do you think that would prove?
With the happy group.
What have you found, Paul?
Well, didn't take long to check out that private eyes report. That rendezvous at the beach house, for example. There isn't a clue as to who might have been there with Bonnie. Just that some man drove there in Hannibal's car.
Who else drives?
Oh, anybody. I always leave the keys in it.
Is there more, Paul?
Enough to believe that Bonnie was secretly mixed up with somebody.
But who?
That's the point. There's only one man that report can absolutely identify. He's a guy that sneaked into Bonnie's house with a package a couple of days before the murder.
What guy? Who was it?
Rex Ainsley.
Yes, I visited Miss Dunbar several times, and I only stayed for a few moments.
What was in the package you brought to her, Mr. Ainsley?
It was a little gift.
What sort of gift?
A pressure cooker.
Pressure cooker?
Yes, her taste in gifts was rather domestic.
Then there were other gifts?
No, that's not what that implies. I've already explained to the district attorney. Our relationship, Bonnie's and mine, was strictly along business lines.
But would you explain it to the court?
Well, I, not to go into boring detail, felt it an obligation to Stanton Press to know what the Stanton family was up to.
The gifts, in other words, were payment to Bonnie for spying at the Stanton house.
It was not really spying.
And you always gave her domestic gifts?
Yes, she hoped to be married soon.
Married? To whom?
She never told me. But I, like everyone else around the Stanton home, thought it was pretty obvious. She and Hannibal.
Why, that no good line.
Order, order in the court, please.
If that hussy was planning to get married, she certainly wasn't acting like it.
Why? What happened?
Well, late that afternoon, I was out of the house for a few minutes, and what I saw when I went in the door was...
I have no further questions of this witness, Your Honor.
You missed him, then.
No, it's not me. I've never considered marriage in any form.
Mr. Dickens, is it necessary for me to put a woman on the stand who saw you kissing Bonnie Dunbar, saw you kissing her the very day she was murdered?
Wait, please. I was only attempting to kiss Bonnie. She resisted me quite successfully, I'm afraid.
Do you expect this court to believe that?
But it's true. Miss Dunbar made it quite plain that my attentions were useless because she was planning to marry someone else. Someone who was about to divorce his wife. Mr. Hannibal Hart.